Hi, this is Ömer Faruk Gülben. I am an employee of Brain Innovation, doing software development and research using MRI data. In this project, we have acquired data from three subjects using 70 MRI at Maastricht University. First, we have acquired MP2 ray images for the whole brain, and then we have acquired 3D multi-echo GRE images. These images were at 350 micron isotropic resolution. We have acquired 6 echoes using bipolar readout, and we have acquired 4 of these runs to increase our SNR by averaging in the post-processing stage. Across these runs, we did 90-degree phase encoding rotations. We had 2 regions of interest when acquiring this data. One was calcarine sulcus, and the other one was Heschel's gyrus. You can see our 6 echoes in this image. And you can realize that there are tiny white spots in all of these echoes. Once we do maximum intensity projection across all echoes and across the Z direction for 7 millimeters, you can realize that these bright voxels indicate the arteries. And there's an interesting artifact related to these arteries that is described first in Larson 1990. Which can be seen by changing the phase encoding direction by 90 degrees. So here you can see that I am changing the phase encoding direction between 2 runs, and all the brain is stable, there's no head motion. However, the arteries are dancing around, so to say. This artifact's behavior can be observed as follows. First, have a look at the blue and the green voxels. Ideally, our T2 star decay should follow the gray curve. However, in the blue voxel, which is in the middle of a big artery, the signal starts high and drops to very low very fast and stays very low, as you can see here. And in the green voxel, you can see that the signal jumps up in the second echo, which is unusual. Of course, if we measure T2 star decay curves as such, we would have erroneous T2 star fits later in the processing. This artifact's behavior can be explained as follows. First, you need to consider the time domain, which is the time difference between phase encoding stage and readout stages, as denoted here by delta T. And together with this time domain parameter, you can also consider the spatial domain, which is here indicated by 2 spins, and one of the spin is moving towards the upper right corner of this image. And with the passing of each time delta t, this spin is moving out. And if you follow the phase and frequency encoding of these 2 spin toy system, you will realize that the measured image will be as follows, which is of course wrong, because in reality this is not the correct location of the spin, and this artifact can be seen as an additive signal that is coming from a spin that is moving in between phase encoding and readout stages. More explanations available in my thesis. This artifact is important to consider for brain regions with large arteries and veins, such as the auditory cortex. Here you can see that in the auditory cortex, large arteries are available, and also together with the very large veins at the same time. This is in contrast to visual cortex, where large arteries are not available. If we zoom in the auditory cortex and near a large artery and follow the signal of our multi-echo GRE image, we would realize that the artifact, the artery signal, is moving outside of the artery and in the direction of the readout axis. Here you can see, even in an extreme case, for a couple of millimeters. If we change the phase encoding axis by 90 degrees, as you can see here, with the denoted, you will realize that the artery signal is now shifting towards another direction. And this was expected, of course, and we exploit this fact when we are averaging these two runs. And we call this stage compositing, which is basically averaging the voxels in these two runs. But we do something a bit more sophisticated for the voxels that has the bright signals in one run and not in the other one. And by doing this compositing, we can get rid of these bright signals in across all echoes. Then we do T2 star fitting, and here are some results. This is from our subject one. You can see like a large coverage here, and then we zoom into the visual cortex and show very easily the tree of Jannari being visible. The white matter gray matter line comes from the T1 image that we acquire. This is our results for subject 2. Similarly, tree of Jannari can be visible. And this is from subject 3. Again, we can easily see the tree of Jannari. Of course, this is not new. Tree of Jannari has been shown in vivo MRI studies many times. However, we use the visual cortex and tree of Jannari as our control condition because we actually want to move towards non-visual cortex areas of the brain and do this high resolution, high precision imaging in those areas. And there we arrive to the auditory cortex. There is some work showing the layers of the auditory cortex, and the question is whether these layers are visible as easily as in the visual cortex case. And to do it, we had both visual cortex and the auditory cortex in our coverage. And we had to address the spatial misencoding artifact. Here I am showing our T1 and T2 star images acquired at one of the subjects around the auditory cortex. You can see the same mushroom-like structure indicating the Heschel's gyrus. And there are several structures of interest in these images. For instance, the red triangle denotes a large artery, and blue triangles indicate veins. For instance, here you can see a large vein sitting in the bottom of a sulcus, and here you can see another vein that is penetrating within the gray matter, and here is another one that's also penetrating. Now we are in the process of basically quantifying all these differences and structures in the auditory cortex similar to the visual cortex at the same time in same people. As conclusions, the spatial misencoding of following spins is a problem for high precision imaging because the T2 star fits or any other analysis will be affected by this highly invasive artifact. This artifact is especially relevant for brain regions near large arteries such as the auditory cortex, but there are also other brain regions near large arteries. This artifact is most visible and traceable in high resolution multi-echo imaging. However, the effects of the same artifact can be seen in other types of images. 90 degree phase encoding direction rotations followed by compositing is an effective mitigation method for this artifact. And this mitigation method has minimal implementation cost because you need to acquire multiple images and average them to increase your SNR anyway at this, for instance, 350 micron isotropic resolution. Thank you.